Hi there, and welcome back to this tutorial about Pixel Stream. My name is William Orving, and I work as a technical artist for Epic Games. In the last tutorial, I showed you how to set up an AWS instance, as well as how to run the Pixel Streaming application on it, and then share it. This tutorial will be dedicated to giving you some extra tips on how to easier run the Pixel Streaming application on AWS. So let's get started. One of the things you might have noticed if you've been using the AWS instance or trying to share the Pixel Streaming application by the IP is that this IP or the public IP of the AWS instance constantly changes. This is because AWS doesn't give you a dedicated IP whenever you launch a new instance. This could be quite irritating if you are trying to share this, for example, with a client. It is quite easy to change this by something called elastic IPs, which I will go through in a second. I just have to show you what I mean with this. So now when this is running, the instance that we set up before, it has a IP of 13.53.190.95. And if I were to stop this, and then just start it again, you'll notice how the IP has changed. Now we want to allocate a elastic IP to this, so go down to that menu on the side here. When in the elastic IP menu, you'll notice that I already have a couple of public IPs here. What we can do to allocate another one is press this allocate elastic IP address on the top right. Select Amazon's pool of IPv4 addresses, allocate, and now you will appear on the old menu, but with the new IP filtered. Have that selected and go for associate elastic IP address. And we will go for the instance in this case. If you click here, you'll notice that all your instances that are running or that you have appear. I know this one on the bottom is the correct one. And then you can select the private IP of that instance, which will automatically appear here. Now we can reassociate this if we want to in the future. So I tend to tick this, but it's not really necessary. Press associate. And you'll notice that this one is now associated with our instance. So let's go back and have a look at that. It's instances. This one is stopped right now, and it still shows another IP. But let's start this and see if it gets the new one, which should be this one down here. Another very useful tool that I tend to use when I run AWS instances as well as using Pixel Streaming on them is the AWS Instance Scheduler. You can look for this just using Google search, and it would probably be the first search result. Now what this does is that you can automatically set up your AWS instance to start and stop whenever you want. So let's say you only wanted to start and stop or only wanted to run during work hours. Then you can do so pretty easily using this tool. And what I tend to do or start off with is just finding this site and then go to launch in the AWS console. Now you will notice if you do it through that website, a link will already be set up in here. So then you can have template that is ready, Amazon S3 URL, and have this in there. Then you can press next. And everything will be set up for you. Obviously, one of the most important parts is having a stack name. Let's just call this Sweden or maybe Stockholm Scheduler, since I work here in Stockholm. Go down to regions. No, default time zone. I don't want the default time zone to be UTC, So I will change that to the one I like, which is Europe and Stockholm. You can change it to whatever you like, really. That's just the default zone. And then the frequency is quite useful important. This is on 5, which is the frequency this schedule will be checking or having a look at if this is running or not. And I tend to use it every 5 minutes to do the check. You don't want to have it too often, because that will be very heavy, while having it too late or not as frequent will not have it stop and start whenever you would like. So I tend to have 5 minutes. That's good. Then I tend to go down to started tax, which should be state equals started, and stop tags should be state equals stopped. Press next. Now we can leave these options as they are. Press next. And you will notice that you can now review it and just have it created by pressing the create stack button. Yes, of course I have to show this. And now we will get back to your cloud formation and your stacks, and you'll notice that it appears here. And it's being created right now, so let's wait a few minutes and come back to here when it's done. When you see that the status of the stack is create complete, you can just edit and change the schedules by going into services, finding DynamoDB under database, go to tables, and you'll notice that the stack that we created a schedule here. Go into config table, items, and here is all the periods and schedules that are set up from the template that we used. Now, you can just take this, or you can just take these names of these if you like, or if you think if they work for you, the times work for you. You can just have this as a tag on your AWS instance, and it should run. Now this, for example, this one is called UK office hours, which is based off the office hours period, which is up here, which is Monday to Friday, 9 to 17. And this schedule is also based, let's see, in Europe, London. Now, when I work from Stockholm, like I do now, I tend to do something similar to this. So you can select one and just select actions, duplicate, and you'll notice that the schedule will appear, or a duplicate of the schedule. So we can rename this how we like. So here's the name of the schedule itself. Let's call that Sweden office hours instead. Like so. Have it based on office hours. If you would like, I can just create a new one called Stockholm office hours and have the time zone set to Europe Stockholm instead. Save this. What we could do, because it will be based off Stockholm office hours, I can save that or copy it. Save, go into office hours, or select office hours, actions, duplicate, and rename the duplicate into Stockholm office hours and have this from 10 to 18 instead, for example. Now we still want this to run on Monday to Fridays, which is good. I can just change the description to Sweden or Stockholm, now that we set that, and save it. Now if everything is set up correctly, we have the Sweden office hours here, which is based on Stockholm office hours, which should be this one, which is Monday to Friday, 10 to 18. And it's based on Europe Stockholm time zone instead. So a very easy way of setting this up now, or when you have set up the period and the schedule you would want it to run, you can just copy the name of the schedule you would like your instance to run on. So I copy this, Sweden office hours, and then I go back to my EC2 instances. I can just go under instances, all states. For some reason, it thinks I'm in Virginia. So let's go to Stockholm. And select the one you would like to run. So in this case, I want to run this one with the schedule Stockholm office hours. Select this, select manage tag, add tag, enter key, which was schedule, and then value of Sweden office hours, and then select save. Now this will not take effect directly, but once you have started this up the first time, it should automatically start at 10 a.m. here in Stockholm and stop at 18 in the evening. So another very useful tool that I tend to use whenever I set up the AWS instance running with the scheduler that I just shown you before is the Windows Task Scheduler. And this is implemented into Windows itself. So this is the AWS instance I'm running right now. And you can just search for the task scheduler, open that up, and create a task, or we will create a task that starts the application whenever Windows or this AWS instance starts. So just select create task, call it start pixel streaming application, for example. Make sure it is set as administrator. You can go in here and just type administrator. To make sure it's the correct one, run with highest privileges and go into triggers, select new, add startup, have it enabled. Press OK, actions, start the program, which you want. Find the original one. In my case, I have set it on the desktop. So that is desktop, Windows No Editor, and just the application. Open that up. Because I didn't choose the shortcut, I can add the arguments right here, which should be audio mixer pixel streaming IP localhost pixel streaming port, which should be 8888, That should be with a big S. Let's just make sure it's correct. And then we need another one, which is called render off screen. And this is because we want this to be able to render or start off even though we're logged out. So you will not see this as usual. It will only start and run when using this argument. Press OK, conditions. Leave them as they are. And the settings could be left as well. Let's have a look at that task. We're going into library. And finding it. Double click it, or you'll see it down here as well. See that everything is set up correctly. And startup. Start a program. Conditions with default settings and settings with default settings. Looks good. Now we would also like to start the turn server batch file, the stun server batch file, and run AWS with turn.batch file. So I will create them here as well. To save some time from this tutorial, I went ahead and created the tasks for the batch files. So this is the start AWS turn server, which you can find in the third party folder in the bottom that I've shown you before, as well as the start stun server, which is in the same place. And then I have the run AWS with turn batch file, which you can find in the programs, Pixel Streaming web server, and Signaling web server folder. The only difference as well with these, which you will notice, is they do not have any arguments, such as this one. So because this is the executable, it has audio mixer and all those arguments, but those arguments are no arguments are needed for these batch files. And the thing I left for the end is this one right here. All of these tasks should be running whether the user is logged in or not. And why I have left this to the end is because if you open this up and you press this, so we had this before, if you press this one and you press OK, you'll notice you need a password. So go into AWS again and get the password, and then you just paste that in here. And when you have these four tasks set up, we can just restart the AWS instance, and all of these should be running automatically, and you will be able to access the Pixel Streaming application through the IP. Now that we're done with the AWS tips, I will take some time to learn how to set this up on an Azure instance as well as a Google Cloud instance. But I will end the Pixel Streaming tutorials here for now and return later with Azure instances as well as the Google Cloud instances. See you then.